Hi Dream Team, welcome back to our channel.
Hey, what's going on everybody? Welcome to another exciting installment of Life is But a Dream with the Makhs. My name is Rato Makheta.
And I'm Peto Lamahe.
And as you can see, we are not rolling alone today. Ladies and gentlemen, back by popular demand, we have got Dr. Jerry Mofokeng wa Makheta with us, as well as Metlodine Mofokeng wa Makheta, the beautiful, incredible yes. couple who happened to be my parents. How are you guys
our
doing?
Our parents.
Oh, by
that's
the way,
what I
we
said.
Are your parents.
Yes. Our parents. That's what I said, guys. I said our parents. Are you guys well?
Good.
So good, thank man. You. Thank you so much
so
for joining us.
Back.
It's such a special day today because today we are celebrating Valentine's Day, and this is why we have got these very special guests with us. Guys, if you don't know, they have an incredible, incredible, very resourceful book out. It is called In Love and Intimate. We're going to put the details in the description below of how you can get a hold of this book and where you can order it. If I mean, they do counseling for countless couples, and so many people just come back and say, guys, you've helped us so much. So if you are interested in getting some tools to help your relationship, go out and get this book. I have read it. My wife has read it. It is absolutely incredible, and it'll definitely help you. You ready to get into it?
Let's get into this one.
Let's get into it, people.
It was the summer of 2008. She said, I would to cook a letter from with a date. Now raise it last 10 years of matrimony on cake. We celebrate. Now we're stronger together. Never better. Go getters, trendsetters, Black Panthers, the anthem. We the Makhs and we only getting better, ay.
Life is what a dream.
So family, 2 months ago we shot an installment called How We Really Met.
A very popular.
Popular. Yeah. And it is actually one of our highest ranking videos. And we don't understand. Maybe there's a method to the madness.
People love love, baby.
People love love. Yeah. People like to know how people met and what attracted people to each other. What was the first impression of, you know, people.
Yeah.
So we're going to ask the folks, Mama le Papa, how did you really meet? We want to hear everything.
How did you really meet?
How did you really meet?
You want us to open the file?
Yes.
Yes. How did we meet?
And when did you meet?
Okay. Before we met, I had a little bit of a drama in my life.
Oh my gosh.
I have a relationship with a Christian sister.
Oh my God.
And she goes to boarding school and falls in love with her teacher. Yes. Oh, wow. These things happen. All right?
Sure.
And so June, July, she comes back. She tells me the silver cup is broken and I'm broken. And I strike a deal with God. Now, sometimes we strike a deal with ourselves and we put God in it. But I say, God, not this year. Nothing. Nothing this year. I want no women. I want no Christian sisters. I want nobody. We'll see about this next year.
Yeah.
August. That was June.
Okay.
August.
2 months later.
Sure.
I see this sister.
Come on.
And you're still heartbroken.
I'm still heartbroken.
Yeah.
And so there are two reasons I should not get into a relationship. One, I have a deal with God. Two, I don't believe in love at first sight.
Okay.
And both of them were broken when I saw her.
Look at God.
You broke all the rules.
Look at God. So what's your impression? So what happens in that moment?
Man, the more I try to pour water onto this thing, the kante I'm pouring paraffin. Boom.
Paint a picture.
I can't. No. I can't sleep. I can't ignore her. And I'm following her all around. And I'm asking her.
Guy, go guys.
Go guys. To find out did you first see this beautiful woman?
At her home.
What were you doing there?
I had taken her brother home.
Okay.
I was. You see, we belong to Youth Alive Ministries,
sure.
And I was one of the leaders.
Sure.
And there is the young Musasono that I'm taking home.
Okay.
And
you're taking the bishop home.
No.
He was Musasono.
Yes. And so as I park the car and he goes around and we chip chatting. There comes this lady with a cap on and this lovely pink dress that had scotch.
Hey.
I can see the picture beautifully. Wow. And I just think, what just happened? What just happened? I love that girl. And then what? I started asking questions.
Mm-hmm.
And the brother got jealous.
Yes.
What's going on? And started asking her, mm-hmm. what's this what's man wrong? Up to?
Mm-hmm.
You know. And sure. and December, I proposed. I broke my contract. I broke my everything.
So about 6 months later.
But you proposed marriage? Or you proposed like to court? I want to be clear. To court.
Okay. No. In our days, that day you propose once and it's the full package.
And it's a wrap.
It's understood.
Come on,
it's
understood. Guys. Come on. Wow. Like, we must go back to those days.
Yeah.
So, Mamzo, so you see this gentleman, and obviously you hear what's happening in your world.
In my world, I'm this Christian.
Oh, bless the Lord.
No nonsense.
Come on, somebody. Turn to your neighbor, no, say glory.
Nonsense Christian girl. I don't mess around. I'm very serious.
Yeah.
Sure.
So I see this guy.
Mm.
We didn't even greet, eh?
Okay.
But later I can see that no man. Who's following who here? And when my brother says, but this man is asking questions, I don't like it. There's a saying
as a brother
in Sesotho, "Lipotla potla lija puji," which means don't run too fast.
Mm. Yeah,
and he would say, you know, "Lipotla potla lija abuji."
That's hilarious.
And you know, later I think we had something at Youth Alive at the club.
Sure.
Where we were exchanging gifts, you know, it's end of the year.
Sorry, so you were attending Youth Alive?
Both of us. Okay. He was a leader for the young people.
Sure.
But he used to attend the young adults. We were young adults.
I'm with you.
So, in this particular evening, it was like a secret pearl something.
Yeah.
Mm. Where you pull somebody's name. And so we had pulled names weeks earlier, and it was the night to exchange the gift.
Sure.
And after that, if I remember, we were supposed to go somewhere. Was it a wedding or something? As a group in a kombi. And
I sat next to her.
Come on.
That was heaven.
But was that strategic? Tell the truth.
He strategized.
He's a man with
what do you mean tell the truth? There's nothing to hide.
Yeah.
I was pursuing.
Yeah. And he's saying, look, I forgot somebody's present. What had happened was the person he was supposed to give the present to was not there, but he left it at the club. I think he was.
Yeah.
Anyway, he proposed.
In December.
Sure.
And I said to him, wait. Then brothers would come and say, you know, God showed me or I prayed. I said, Lisile. I'm also going to pray.
Oh, other brothers.
It was, you know, a general thing. People would say, you know,
God showed me that you are my person.
So I said to him, you were shown, you prayed. Don't you think I should also pray?
Yeah.
So please leave me alone. I'm going to pray.
Okay.
And sorry, baby, I'm interested to find out what year this was and how old you both were.
That was 1978, December.
Okay. And age?
22.
Yeah. Wow, you were young.
Yes.
Wow.
So, it so happened that he took the younger people to camp for 2 weeks.
About a week.
A week.
Yeah.
He took the young people to camp, and that sort of gave us this leeway. He's there, I'm there, and... But I'm praying.
Okay.
Yes. And I roped my prayer partner in to say, hey,
who was that?
Something like this. Naniki, a lady by the name of Naniki.
Shout out to you.
Yeah.
Hey.
Naniki.
Menaniki.
I roped her in and told her, hey, friend, it's like this and like this. Please help me pray. Oh, that's okay. Amazing. I got your back. After they came back from, you called me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, as they were away.
Like on
On the phone, that phone,
like the house phone.
No, no, you were at camp.
Yes.
No, no, he called your home.
No,
like,
no.
Yeah.
I was at work.
Okay.
Natal Spring Hospital.
And I had just been allocated to the ICU during the training.
Yeah.
And I saw, you've got a phone call. I said, who, me?
Yeah.
I don't get calls at work. Serious, you've got a call. Hello. Oh, it was him. And I'm like, I prayed. I'll come back to it. I prayed, and I think I said to him, I can't wait to see. What did I say?
I'm also missing you.
I'm also missing you. And he dropped.
Okay.
He said, oh, okay, where can I see you? But he dropped in case I changed my mind.
Sure. So, but now before, sorry, Mums. So before, when you pick up the phone to make this call,
yes,
is your heart pounding? Like, what's going on? Are you breaking out in sweats? Are you, what's, where are you?
Him.
Me.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm at camp. And it's these boor farmers.
Yeah.
And you're not supposed to be using the phone.
Mm.
You're supposed to just run your camp, and there are no cell phones.
Mm.
So I negotiate and I beg, and please, these people change wards and so on.
Yes.
But I tracked her and found which ward that, and which shift.
That was like, if I die, I die. We're going in.
Yeah.
Sure, so, brilliant.
So what actually happened was, I dream a lot.
Okay.
Mm.
So I had a dream where Naniki and I had gone to her home in Binoni.
Mm.
And for you, from Binoni to Natal Spirit, where the hospital was, you have to pass through SNRS.
Okay. Mm.
We were coming back from Naniki's house and there was a flood. Naniki was with his brother, who had a plaster of Paris up to the knee, up to the thigh.
Mm.
He had been in an accident. So here's this flood. We look at the time, we have exactly 30 minutes to be in the ward working. And then things were so strict. It was either you are there or you get dismissed.
Sure.
So we look at each other and I'm like, what are we going to do? He says, I will carry you on my back. Ooh. So we look at each other with Naniki. Naniki goes, it means the training is gone. Jumped on his back and we went over to the other side. Then I woke up.
Wow.
So
wow,
this dream I had when I was home, I was off, day off, in the morning, and I go to my mom, Ma, I had such and such a dream. She just laughed. Says, I'm coming, make tea. So over tea, she tells me, your grandmother, your father's mother, had a similar dream.
Sure.
Where she was supposed to make a very big decision of whether to get married or not. But this man carried her, I think, through fire, something like that. But now, the complication is, at that time, it's not there in my heart. You know, much as I said he should wait, but I'm not feeling him. Sure, it you know, it was punishing me so much.
Yeah.
The day when I told him, I'm missing you, what had happened was, December month is my birthday. It was around my birthday. And he had said he wants to take me out in the dream.
Okay.
He wants to take me out. And I dreamt we went to a cinema, movie cinema, and the building was at the peak of a mountain. And we actually had to look at it like this. And I looked at him, I said, like, how? He said, don't worry. He carried me, started, you know, like climbing the mountain. His back was wet from sweat. We reached the peak and I woke up. And I'm like, God, but something clicked at that time. that doubt and everything just disappeared, and I just felt, you know what? I want
that's
this
my man.
But you know, I'm interested to find
that's
out, Mama,
so amazing.
How do you, when I'm listening to your story, what made you want to give him a chance? Because for you, for him, it was an instant connection of
yes.
I am mutu o kimutwaka. Howing. But
yeah.
for you were wrestling with God, and what did you see in him that made you feel like I could actually give this guy a chance, and I want to give him a chance, but let me wait for
God
to confirm
yeah.
something in my
for
heart.
Sure. That's a good question.
You know what? At that time, I think as young people, we were very mindful of what does God say in everything.
Sure.
You know, it was so
sure,
part
that's
of
so
us,
good. That's so good.
And we wouldn't sway. If it was God, I would rather die. I'm going to do it.
Sure.
So he happens to call.
It was God's way or nothing.
Yes. He happens to call after I had that second dream.
Wow.
Which was now a stamp.
So when he called, I said, yo, I like to see you. And believe it, he had arrived from camp. He arrived that afternoon.
Yo.
Okay. So you arrive in the afternoon and she said...
I please understand telephone communication is a problem.
Yes.
So I go from Orlando West next to Hector Peterson Memorial.
Where you
I
grew
go
up.
To yeah, where I grew up. And I go to Orlando Post Office next to the police station across the river.
Yeah.
And I go to make a call to her to say, can I come visit? It's the 2nd of January, 1979.
Yeah.
She says yes. She says yes. So I get into taxis to town.
Faraday Station.
And I get taxis to
into train. You came by train.
Train to Faraday Station.
Yeah.
Taxi to Natal Springs. And then I have to go to the nurse's home. And waits there, and she appears.
Woo!
So,
come on.
And is that, as they say, the rest is history.
Woo! I was walking on air, walking home. I was, my sister-in-law just says, "What happened?"
Bokomi.
Hey.
2nd of January 1979, historic day.
Sure.
That's incredible.
Wow.
That's incredible.
That is special.
That is that.
That and
guys, you know, things were so simple back then.
Yeah.
You guys were spoiled.
They were simple but hard.
Complicated.
But complicated.
Yeah.
Simple but complicated.
But because you had to work for it.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? You don't take it for granted.
Yeah.
I don't know, but that's just me. This is an absolutely incredible story.
So you get
married when?
2 years later.
2 years later. Guys, this is what's so crazy is our story is exactly like it's exactly the same. Okay. So 2 years later after you meet, you get married.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, let's say 18 months later.
18.
So it's
because 79, 2nd of January,
and
June 19th is when we
incredible.
Get married.
Incredible.
So you get married and so you are 24 and 24 respectively, yes?
Yeah, I was 23 and a half. He was 24.
Okay.
Sure. Cool. I had just turned 24.
Yeah.
All right. One of the themes in speaking about your relationship in a lot of the talks that you've had, which I've had the privilege of being a part of, you always talk about how love must be serviced. I'm hoping that we can just unpack that a little bit. What do you mean by that when you say love must be serviced? And if you could personalize it as much as possible.
First of all, a disclaimer. The day we got married.
Yeah.
Her dad made that statement.
Wow. Okay.
Love must be serviced.
Beautiful. Okay.
And we took ownership of that.
Sure.
And Papa, you always say that.
Yeah, yes.
Absolutely. You see, there's no, you're going to get onto the freeway, auto cruise, set the speed, and just hold the steering. No. You work. When you're a farmer, you work that field. Autumn comes, you till the ground, and winter comes, you do what you ought to do. Before spring comes, you plant, and then you take the weeds out, and then you water. All those things you do, you find out what your partner's love language is, and it never expires.
And I also have to pick up on when my dad said that, it made me look back. I watched him servicing the love. I watched him, you know, he was a teacher. He would come home, you know, teachers stopped at 2 o'clock. He would come home earlier. Like, hey, I've got a headache. Okay, mama. Okay, darling. And then she'll be bringing tea, and he would be saying, let's go to the bioscope. How?
Okay.
And then
wow.
It was an excuse. He played like he had a headache just so that he can take the wife out.
Oh, shame, and man.
You know, there are moments. I remember we were speaking with my brother the other day, and he said, hey, we were still young. He says, you know, he asked me to take him to town. He had bought mom a watch, 18 karat gold. You know, he put it in the inside pocket of the jacket. Along the way, he kept pulling it out, looking at it, smiling, and putting it back. Just like that. Hey, urata mama.
Oh, man.
Exactly. And you know what? That man was full of love. And I remember the day he saw my first house, a flat. It was a flat, 3-bedroom flat, a very beautiful, beautiful flat. And after he went round, he said, you know what? This has been my wish to buy your mom something like this, but time is against me. You know, he was always looking for opportunities to make this woman
to minister
happy,
to her.
You know,
yeah,
he nursed her when she was sick. He nursed her. I'm told when I was about one, my mom got so sick. He was in hospital for so long that I forgot her. I was staying with my dad. He was taking me to school with him and back. I had to be reintroduced to my mother. But he was there every day at the hospital. So my mom, you know, tells me towards the end of her life, she was telling me that, you know what? I remember I would have given up a long time ago, but love made me stick around.
Sure.
She says, when I was sick, each time when I wanted to give in, I would see your father next to me and I would come back.
Wow.
You know, so I suppose when you grow up seeing that and that statement, love has to be serviced. I remembered all that, but your dad, I mean, he lived up to that, even though he was not part of the unfolding according to me. But you know, I've experienced everything, the surprises, the surprises, he learning my love language, this woman loves, you know, fragrances, shoes, bags, and he does all that.
So I wonder, it's actually very interesting, mama, when you say that, because so mama always says, wait a pet. Nah, I wanna underwear. The perfume. Hakereke pet.
Yeah.
Man. I wanna say to the pet. Hakereke. And you know, I can attest to the perfume. Obviously, I haven't seen the underwear, but I can attest to the perfume. Mama has like a collection of perfume.
Yes.
You know. So what? When you how to buy, mama? What I'm interested in is, I feel like sometimes women's love languages are so common, you know, gifting and rather soft life, you know, and that makes us really happy. So I'm interested to find out for Papa, what ministers to Papa? How do you service your love, you know?
Yes.
From a woman's perspective, because I feel like for men are so easy, man. Like, you know, but sometimes can be easy but complex.
Yes, that's true.
So how do we service these gentlemen here?
With him,
yes,
he loves to be babied.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in the baby,
yeah,
is the validation.
Sure.
You know.
Sure.
You know, he is a simple man. Mm. But complicated.
Yeah.
Mm. In that, he loves his food. Mm. He's got allergies. I got that. Mm. Yeah. I know what he has to eat. But the how. Yeah. He's happier if I serve him in a pot.
Hmm.
Huh.
Nothing wrong.
Mm.
Interesting.
You know?
Yeah.
He says, hey, you've got me.
Yeah.
You know?
It's the little things.
The little things. Because we complicate love by prescribing.
So true.
Listen to what the other person says. It might be bizarre, but if they ask for it, give it to them.
Wow.
The babying is whenever I go shopping, I have to bring him something. That which I bring there.
That is so cute.
The grandchildren, I know that there's his version of that.
For sure.
And
for
there's
sure.
nothing wrong.
Yeah.
And he's a person that keeps in touch.
Yeah.
When he's not home.
Yeah.
How are you? Good night. That's his keeping in touch.
Mm.
When he's coming back home, he'll say, I'm coming back. I'll be home in so many minutes.
Mm.
That has taught me that when someone has a love language, they expect the other to do the same.
To reciprocate.
Mm.
So I have to remember also to update him.
Mm.
And sometimes I forget and I find him livid.
Mm.
So that tells me, oh, okay. I don't just say, here's my love language and just sit back.
Yeah.
It means I also have to return the favor.
Sure.
And if both of us do that, then there won't be any challenges.
I love that. The common thing in everything that you've said regarding dad's love language for me is consideration.
Yes.
It's yes. Consider me.
Are you thinking
which
about
is very
me?
Much my wife.
Mm. Yes.
As well.
So I'm
like,
Papa.
Yes.
And you're and your mama.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love to be baby.
You love to yeah, for sure.
I love to be spoiled.
Sure.
I love to be considered.
Yeah. Okay.
And you like to be validated.
I love to be validated.
And
acknowledged.
Yes. When you come, I've learned.
Yes.
When you come into a room,
yes.
I stop what I do.
Aww.
Because I've learned that, oh, okay.
And attention.
You love attention. Not in a bad way,
that's
but
beautiful.
Acknowledge me. I'm
wow.
here.
Sure,
oh, stop whatever and say, how are you? Not condescending.
Like I want you to see me.
Exactly. And yet, I have 5 children who are not like you. But I had to learn
me. Sure.
Yes.
And then let me wow. let me say this. Let me say this.
I'm getting emotional. Okay.
I got for more than 20 years, I had problems with, we go on holiday.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
My wife goes and sits and reads.
Yeah.
And I want us to go and watch the animals.
Yeah.
And all these wild things go deep in the sea. No, she wants to read us. Sweetheart. No! Get it together! And so, when we were shooting
Mama Jack
in Cape Town, and what's that hotel?
Bay.
The Bay Hotel.
Mm.
In Kemp's Bay.
Mm.
Woo!
Mm.
And I say, part of my payment, they must fly it down.
Mm.
And they rent me a car.
Mm. Mm.
And then I think, hey, but she likes books, but what am I going to do? So what do? I bought the books. Wow. She gets there, there's a table full of magazines. Sure. The ones I've seen her read and the ones I have not seen her read. Mm. We had honeymoon.
Sure.
I feel like give, such a rookie. I'm so like, wait, what?
Like, what have you been doing?
What have I been doing all my life?
Don't judge a person on what they should love. Mm. And how they should receive love.
Yeah.
Love a person the way they want to be loved.
Sure.
And you don't need to be a sangoma, you don't need a prophet. It's there. Mm. She wants to read and watch soapies. And then we can go and eat.
Mm-hmm.
And then me and my daughter, Mpo, we can wake up at 3:30 and go and watch animals behave like animals.
Sure.
Not wake her up to go and watch animals behave like animals.
Wow.
No. So, as I fill the table with the novels, with the reading stuff.
Guys, I... I've got no words.
I mean, I thought I knew. Amazing. I thought I knew, but I didn't know. Guys, go and get this book.
Mm.
It's absolutely incredible. Thank you so much, folks.
Thank you so much
for sharing your story with us and just imparting knowledge and love. And this is our heart for you. You know.
Yeah.
I've got so much to learn. I'm feeling a little bit inadequate. But you know what, God, right?
Yeah. We're also right? still learning.
Oh, you know another thing, baby, before it's a
Another
thing that Papa doesn't compromise on.
Yeah.
Every year, beginning of the year, we saw Mama holiday.
That's true.
Every year, I don't want to leave this
COVID
platform
or
without,
no COVID.
Without talking about this because it's something that he has committed to do and he's been doing it for the past however many years. And I think it's absolutely beautiful. And they're so cute, like they'll send pictures.
Yeah, in gowns.
Like, in gowns. They're like, ooh.
Like, hey, what are you two up to? What's going on here?
And they'll send us like the room tour.
And it
ministers to us as well to see her baby.
Sure.
Okay, we're 10 years in. This is
41.
This is 41 years in.
41
so,
this
so,
year, yeah.
So this is what we could attain. This is what we could achieve in the next 30 plus years. And it's possible.
Yes, I like that. Achieve in so many years. It doesn't just... And I have to add, it's us now, but throughout the years, we took the children with.
That's true.
Yes,
that's
took
true.
Our children
sure.
along.
Okay.
For sure.
And we would downsize a bit because there were many of us.
Yeah.
Yes. But yes, for the sake of just going out with as family and with time, now it's us because the nest is getting empty.
Wow.
Please don't forget to like, subscribe, share, turn on your notifications to
and
know
comments.
Every time we and we love your comments, guys.
We
love your comments. Thank you for I'm really moved right now. I don't even know what to say.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for loving on us as we love you. Thank you for continuing to serve us with your love as we serve you with content. We love you. I love you. I love you, folks.
And folks, any parting words?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Any valelising words?
You know, I like to say people should keep it simple. Let us not complicate things. Find out how she wants to be loved, how he wants to be loved, and just exercise that. You'll see.
Yeah. Thank you.
Men and women want to be loved differently. Just love your partner the way they want to be loved. Don't prescribe. No.
Sure.
Just because we're not with this Scottish lady burger here, now you put Tatala the perfume. Give her what she wants to have. That's it.
Yeah.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is another epic installment of
Life is But a Dream. with the Makhs.
Makhs. We love you.
We love you guys.
Thank you.
Peace and blessings.
Bye.